Hello everybody, welcome to our new Let's Play of Dark Souls 2. We have already played Dark Souls 1 on the channel. And we have decided to make this Let's Play online. And we are gonna do co-op, or at least try.
Yeah, and we also kinda did this episode, or at least did an attempt on this,
Let's Play. Yeah.
Yeah.
It didn't go very well. We were really tired at the moment, and it really fucked us up. So we're just gonna do it again, but this time online, which is a new experience because we haven't done this before.
So it's basically a new experiment.
Yes, it's a little bit of a new experience for us and experimenting with the game. I'm gonna start the game, by the way.
Let's play.
Yeah. If you haven't played Dark Souls 2 before, the way that you do co-op is really convoluted and weird and stupid, but it's a new experience because we haven't done this before.
So it's basically a new experiment.
Yes, it's a little bit of a new experience for us and experimenting with the game. I'm gonna start the game, by the way.
Let's play.
Yeah. If you haven't played Dark Souls 2 before, the way that you do co-op is really convoluted and weird and stupid, but it's a new experience because we haven't done this before.
So it's basically a new experiment.
Yes, it's a little bit of a new experience for us and experimenting with the game. I'm gonna start the game, by the way. Sometimes really funny stuff happens. This is actually the biggest reason why I want to do this thing, I think.
Yeah.
Well, that and also I have to complete this game before he gets to play Dark Souls 3, which has to happen. I'm so in the mood for teaching him the wondrous world of Dark Souls 3. But we first have to get through this hellhole. And I wanted to do it in co-op. Because there are some bosses in this game, and if you have to fight them alone, they just suck.
Yeah,
and even if you have to do co-op, they suck.
Some bosses you have to fight alone.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that's right. But some, the ones you have to fight alone aren't too bad.
Yeah, well, I really hate the rat.
Oh yeah, the royal rat, yeah.
I hate him. Oh my god.
Well, when we get there, you can rage all you want. I still really like this cutscene. It's really good quality. When you think about it.
What?
The quality of the cutscene is really good.
Yeah. It actually is.
How could you be? All of those stupid drakes. Oh boy. Chop off their toes!
Yeah, it's actually true.
Yeah.
Because you don't have a fucking clue what you're doing there. It's like, oh yeah, I'm here, but what the fuck am I doing?
The reason is why you are going there, that's the convoluted.
Yeah. It's actually pretty weird you're doing it, but you never really know why you're doing all the stuff you're doing.
Yes.
In Dark Souls, that's... Yeah.
Well, I think in Dark Souls 3, it's better than when you think about when you blah, 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 blah. The reason why you're doing stuff, there's an actual reason behind them. I think only this game has it, that there's not much reason behind the stuff you do. Because you're like, okay, you have been drawn to the world of the undead, basically. Because you are hollow and all that jazz. Or you got inflicted with a curse, and the reason why you're doing this whole adventure is to get rid of the curse, basically. That's it. That's the reason why you're doing this. You're trying to get rid of the undead curse.
Yeah.
But it's not gonna be as easy as just walking around and saying like, hey, can you get rid of my curse? Sure, for 1,000 souls. Okay.
There you go.
That was a reference to the guy in the first game, by the way, that heals you from curse. I think it's 1,000 souls or something. I don't remember. Is your fate. The fate of the cursed. And now you need to like plug in the cutscene of Conqueror's Bad Fur Day. You are dead! With the Grim Reaper, it's fucking amazing. I really think about playing sometime, but it's gonna really happen because the controls and the gameplay is kind of shitty. Oh well, we've played Jak 2, so yeah. We can handle anything after that game.
Yeah, pretty much.
This game looks freaking good. And it also runs good, which is two things that I really like. This is probably one of the only games that I can do this with.
Yeah, and the thing is it's also a PC game.
So yeah, it's actually optimized for a PC compared to the rest of the Dark Souls.
Always a bit glitchy. PC games are always a bit glitchy.
Yeah, that's a fact. Okay, so you start off the game in this weird ass plane with nothing except your fists of fury, half health, and weird ass cloaks. But if you've seen Dark Souls 1, you kind of understand what everything means on the screen already. I'm not gonna explain too much because I suck at explaining in English. So.
Sit over here. Oh, yawn. Bit glitchy.
Yeah, that's a fact. Okay, so you start off the game in this weird ass plane with nothing except your fists of fury.
Please don't look at this.
Nope. We are not supposed to be an example. We are two idiots playing a game that we like.
Yeah, basically.
Which is basically everybody on YouTube. Well, at least everybody thinks they're an idiot. Man, the amount of yawning already. Jesus.
Yeah,
it's only 3 p.m., goddammit.
Nah.
What?
What?
No, I didn't hear what you said.
Oh. I didn't, please.
Man, the amount of yawning already. Jesus. I still like.
Yeah.
I have no idea why. They're creepy as heck, but aside from that, I like them just laughing at you constantly.
Yeah.
Retire, by the way. Did you know that?
Yeah, but he told me.
Okay, yeah. I don't know what I... Oh, a name.
Fun time.
Oh, name. Shit, I was supposed to think about this before the episode. Let's see, can I make a snazzy reference? Nah, sure.
Something original.
Let's see, can I make a snazzy reference? Get this thing on. Up. Whoops, not two. S. Sure. Or was it worlds or words? I don't remember. You know what? We're probably gonna skip, by the way.
Yeah, probably.
I have a fucking good idea.
Tell me.
I'm not gonna tell you the name that I... should I really go for this name? No, not gonna... Nah, fuck, no. It would have been a good idea, but it's too lame. I need something original, like freaking Downtown Crag. That was such a good name. I need to find a reference or a name in a game.
Tell me.
I'm not gonna tell you the name that I... should I really go for this name? No, not gonna... Nah, fuck, no. It would have been a good idea, but it's too lame. I need something original, like freaking... Why can't I write freaking long names in this game?
I'm gonna cool off minus spelled height.
Sure, this is funny enough. You still know your own name.
Here's your reward.
Yeah, that's it. No, fuck you.
It's a human effigy.
Take a closer look.
Was Dark Souls 2 your first experience with Dark Souls?
Yeah, it was.
It was the same for me. That's the lovely thing about this.
Here's your reward.
Yeah. Introduced us in the Soul series.
Who?
But this time we're no longer noobs, we're only semi-noobs. Okay, class. I'm going to go for something. The thing is, I'm going to be using Dexterity and Miracles in this playthrough. I want to make a Dexterity and Miracle build. Now, I have to just find the right freaking character for this. I could also just go Deprived, really. But the problem with Deprived is the fact that you don't have a lot of the other stats, which kind of screws with you in the beginning of the game.
Yeah.
Well, you know what, fuck it, I'm gonna go Deprived. What am I gonna get from item? I think I'm gonna get a petrified something. I like petrified somethings. Alright, ooh. Ah, dang, I could have been a female. Well, you know, my name is already going towards male, so yeah.
I think I'm gonna my character name on at least try.
What are you gonna do?
Do my character name proud.
Ah. You don't have a lot of hairstyles in this game, it kinda sucks.
I think I'm gonna go bandit because I never really well been a bandit. So yeah, let's go.
Never been a bandit.
No.
Wow. I could just make it freaking ridiculous. Sure. Let's go.
Should I take the seed of a tree of giants or the petrified something?
I think a petrified something might be better. It's either I always choose either the petrified something, the healing wares, or the bonfire aesthetic. Because the if you choose which one are you gonna choose? If you choose the Seed of a Giant Tree, it's only useful online and that's it.
Yeah.
So yeah. Oh, I'm gonna. Are you gonna give yours a beard?
No.
No? Okay. Yeah. Oh yeah. This is gonna look amazing. Wait, that's a little bit too light, yeah. Let's see.
And make the guy look like him.
So also we won't be able to see each other until we start the freaking game.
Yeah, I'm just gonna mesh random. Holy shit. Ugh. The fuck? Oh. Random. Please.
I don't think I'm gonna mess too much with the way that my character's face looks. Yeah, I'm gonna leave my character's face for like just a generic face because I don't really want to screw too much around it.
I think I found him. Okay, I wanna give you a beard though, like a full beard.
All right, I think I'm done. Yep, I'm done.
All people come here for the same reason. To break the curse.
To break the curse. And there you go, there's your objective.
Yeah.
Doesn't stand a chance. You bitch!
I found myself.
You found your true self. Yeah. The funniest thing about all this is the fact that we won't be able to see each other's name and each other's looks until we are like through the beginning of the game, basically.
Yeah, that's right. That's pretty funny.
You know why they made it so that that you basically run up to these people and then you can change yourself?
Tell me.
Because they give you a humanity and because then they can render the same character in this cutscene. Instead of having to either leave your character out of this or make it so that your character is visible. Hmm. Alright. And let's wait a second. There you go. I'm here. I literally give off light, which is amazing. You white guy. You know what, I think the way that my character looks from hairstyle and all that jazz, I think it really fits what... It doesn't, maybe not, doesn't really fit his name, but it fits the thing that I'm gonna do with him, so... Alright, bonfire. So for the people that don't know it, bonfires are your checkpoints in Dark Souls. Come on, there we go.
I've got an extra human energy.
I have no idea why, but I have some kind of a debuff that I have never seen before.
Hmm.
Or a buff or debuff, I don't know if it's... Huh, that's weird.
Are we gonna do the tutorial thingy?
I'm gonna do it for the items, because there are a couple of magic items that I'm gonna use.
Items and maybe a bit of souls.
Yes. No, well, you can choose if you don't want to do it, it's not necessary. But the thing is, you also get a dagger over here, which is your only weapon that you can get when you go deprived. Which it seems like we both were, so yeah. Oh no, you're a bandit, right?
No, I'm a bandit.
Yeah, okay.
A bandit.
Are you one of those Fire Emblem bandits? Like the really dumb looking bandits? Remember when I showed you that one mission from Fire Emblem?
No, I'm not one of those.
No, but... The thing is, do you remember that mission?
I'm not sure.
It was with Jasmine. Like, one of them was named Jasmine. Yeah. I haven't gotten to that point of the game quite yet. Again.
Okay.
Bonk. Oh, hi. There we go.
Hey, got a bow.
Uh-huh.
Cool.
And there's my key to victory. A dagger. Run, bitch, run! And I didn't manage to stab him, so I'm just gonna attack him.
For some reason, I'm holding up my guard when I'm dual wielding my axe. I don't know if that's normal, but I'm doing it.
Wait. So you're constantly guarding when you...
Yeah, it looks like it.
Hmm. That might be that might be a controller error.
Yeah, probably. I don't know, don't really care. Wow.
Well, when we run into trouble, we can fix it off camera. Well, a controller issue in Dark Souls, this is pretty dang important to fix. Because otherwise you won't be able to get far into the game.
Yeah, but it's not really affecting me, so...
Well, not right now, but when you have a shield and you're constantly blocking.
Yeah, but it's only when I'm dual wielding, looks like it.
Hmm. Weird. Oh well.
Yeah.
And I get the white ring. Cool. I can look like a phantom now. Because I want to look like a freaking white ass phantom. Give us smooth, give us silky. I shall give you nothing, because I don't have anything anymore. I'm even more deprived than before. Now I only have a ring that makes me white. God damn it.
Yeah, you white guy.
You're a white guy. Okay. I am gonna miss parrying. Now that we're not playing Dark Souls 1 anymore, I'm gonna miss parrying. Yeah. But I'm still gonna try to parry, but it's probably not gonna work.
Parrying is okay, actually.
Well, you have been parrying more than me in the other co-op later that we did.
Oh, I think I've got something for you, because I got a channeler's trident.
A channeler's trident, that's good. Because you can give it to me and then I can kind of be your buff guy. Because I'm gonna be using miracles also, so I can heal you when you need to.
Okay.
But then you have to stay close to me, but we'll see how that goes when we get there. It's gonna take a while before we get there anyway. Right, and I missed. Nice. There we go. Stabbed him in the face. Now, everybody who normally plays Dark Souls 2 and they start off a game, and they've already played it before, then they usually don't really care about this tutorial area. But I'm a completionist at heart, so I like to do this stuff.
I see.
If there are people that haven't seen anything of Dark Souls before, well, then they get to see everything about Dark Souls 2 now. Well, probably not everything, but a lot, any case.
Yeah.
We're gonna try to get to as many areas as we can. We are definitely going to beat all of the bosses.
Yeah.
That is something that we will do. Because not beating all of the bosses would just be lame.
Classic Majula music.
Yes.
Ugh, don't know, whatever the fuck you want to call it. I like it.
I also like it. It gives you, like, when you've just come back from one of the DLC areas almost dead, or beaten to a pulp, and then you hear this music, it's like, ugh.
It's still weird that you're
not beating all of the bosses would just be lame.
Classic Majula music.
Yes.
Ugh, don't know, whatever the fuck you want to call it. I like it.
I also like it. It gives you, like, when you've just come back from one of the DLC areas almost dead, controls the way it plays. Dark Souls 2 plays a lot different than Dark Souls 1. Like, it feels a lot different also.
Yeah, by the way, I'm gonna skip most of the text.
Yeah, I'm also gonna skip most of the text. I'm not gonna listen to all of the text, I'm sorry. Because if you want this, then you can look at some kind of a lore playthrough, but we are just trying to get through the game and we're not trying to waste too much time on camera.
Because time is precious.
Because what?
Time is precious.
You are his precious?
No, time.
Oh, time is precious. Oh, whoops, sorry. We very good English.
Yeah.
Well, it's not as bad as I thought it would be, actually. I thought that I was gonna be abysmal at my English today, but it turns out to be decently fine. There we go. Don't forget to get the Estus Charge in Majula.
Nope.
Because I meant... Sorry. We very good English.
Yeah.
Well, it's not as bad as I thought it would be, actually.
I think you can find an Estus Charge or something like that very close.
Wait, what?
Yeah, I think it's an Estus Charge if you kick the rock in the water.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's the one that I mentioned.
Yeah.
I get the Estus Flask from the Emerald Herald. Now we have to listen to all of our bullshit. And then we can level up. And I don't have enough souls to level up. Nice.
Me neither.
Upgrade Estus Shard.
Page
and there we go. Strengthened. Okay, so now we have two Estus. Two freaking Estus Flask. You drink Estus in this game really slowly. Let me just explain one thing about Dark Souls 2. If I take a look at help over here. When you upgrade your adaptability, you will get all kinds of different stats. You will basically have get like magic defense and bleed and all that jazz. But the most important one is agility over here. Your agility, the higher your agility is, the more invincibility frames you have when rolling. Because right now you don't have that much. I would get agility to level 100 at least, and then your rolling will be good, and you will also be able to drink your Estus faster. So it's just gonna... I like to call it the survivability stat, because you need to level up this stat in this game if you want to get through it.
Yeah.
To which point are we gonna play in this session? On this first episode? Maybe we should play until we get the soapstone.
Yeah.
The next episode we can start doing co-op. We also need to keep our soul level in mind.
Oh yeah, right.
And also our we have to, the first moment that we can, we have to buy that one ring to get to get our co-op going. So I suggest that you leave your souls for now, and then we can, like, you should spare up your souls until to get that ring. Did you see how many souls we needed for it? Because I didn't.
Me neither.
I'll go and take a look when I get to the next bonfire. Where do you get the red soapstone again? From the guy in after the skeleton boss battle.
Oh yeah.
After the chariot. My least favorite boss battle in this game. Be free, my master! And then he gets squished.
Squish, squish, squish.
Get squished! Did you know that I named... Whoa! Did you know that I named one of my Dark Souls 3 characters who used great hammers? I named him Mr. Squishy. Which was an amazing name. Some names were really stupid that I made, but some of them were amazing. I like the name that I gave this character, so...
Why is my stamina re-thingying so slow?
Because you're constantly guarding. No, when you're guard... No, but when you guard and you block, then your stamina recharges really slow.
Huh, then
Then you are.
Huh. It's only when I'm dual wielding that I'm...
You should see if you can find a shield. Wait. Go back over to Majula and go into the tower, towards Hate's Tower of Flame, and then you can find a chest with a shield in it, and then you can test it out.
Is there something that...
Let's see. So you have to spare up 5,500 souls. To get to the ring that we need.
No, for some reason, only when I'm dual.
So, did you try it with a shield?
I don't have a shield.
Go back to Majula, go towards Hate's Tower of Flame, and then there should be a chest with a shield in it.
Oh yeah, right.
It's a crappy shield, so I'm not gonna get it, but you can get it. For some kind of a reason, in this game there are not a lot of 100% physical block shields in this game. Or at least not from the regular shields.
Holy shit.
Holy shit.
Yeah. I almost died.
Jeez.
Because I wasn't paying attention. Get that shield.
Ah, crap.
Crap sticks?
Crap sticks, yeah, right.
Mr. Crab.
Mr. Crabs. I'm wondering if I have input delay or my controller is just being weird. Yikes! Okay, that guy from the back passage. And now I give him a stab in the back passage. And now we have this one archer douchebag. The thing is, I think this is one of the first time that times that I've actually played this game with my new controller.
Oh, nice.
Because the last time that we did this playthrough, I think I used my old controller still. Well, I could still use it. It's not broken, but...
Hey, now I'm not doing it for some reason.
Huh.
Fuck.
When you equip the shield, or...?
No.
No, when you're dual wielding again.
That's random.
Oh, wow.
Stop doing it.
That's weird.
Oh, hi.
Oh, yeah, but you're using the 360 thingamajig. That program. Right? Aren't you using the Xbox 360 controller emulator shenanigans?
Yeah,
that's probably the reason why it's so buggy. When that happens, you should, I think, reset. If you reset the game, it shouldn't happen anymore.
Yeah, but I'm fine.
As long as... The thing is, I've had this happen to me in Dark Souls 3, I think. And one time I accidentally attacked the Firekeeper, and she died. And that is the moment where I basically rage quitted. Because I was like, nope, don't want to deal with this.
Oh my god, that sucks. Wait,
so, and the thing is, the Firekeeper in Darkest 3 respawns. I didn't know that, but she respawns. In this game, if you kill the Emerald Herald, she dies for real. So, yeah.
Oh, fun times.
The thing is, it only happened when I spammed the A button, I would attack. Because I was spamming the A button to skip the text, but then my character, for some kind of reason, attacked. Oh, right, I forgot about this douchebag. On his freaking ladder. You must get stabbed and die! And then he punches me in the face before he dies. Oh. No, I don't want to climb, I want to get inside. Also, my apologies for at my end, you might be able to hear me pressing the buttons on my controller. But I have to sit so close to my screen because my cable for my headphones is quite short. Yeah, I've noticed this in my other videos that I made, so yeah.
Also happened that the Saint-Ear spear.
Oh yeah, the Saint-Ear spear, yeah.
I want it. Give it to me.
Well, I'm not sure, does it scale with strength?
I don't remember. I think it scales with strength and dexterity. Hey, I see a summon sign. SSS. S.
Ass! Holy crap, I don't have enough stats to use a short sword. My character is horrible! I'm some kind of a... Well, actually, you know what? This totally fits my character, actually, the fact that I started with this. Oh, boy! I I was getting on the ladder, and I was automatically pressing B twice to go to slide down the ladder from Dark Souls 1.
Yeah.
And I just released the ladder. I was like, oh, fuck. But I managed to survive, so... No prabs.
No! Fuck! Oh, shoot.
Never forget that we're playing Dark Souls. Me having to spam my freaking locking on button like crazy. I've noticed that with my controller right now, I think I dropped it once by accident. And since then my bumper buttons haven't been working perfectly. Which really sucks. Yeah, I got a helm.
Fuck!
Well, I like seeing my mohawk.
Holy shit, Estus is so slow.
Yeah.
Oh, no, 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 don't eat me!
Don't eat me.
No,
are you fighting the freaking ogre?
Yeah.
Wow, that's insane. Well, the thing is, you can technically beat the ogre. I can't beat the ogre with a dagger. I get one shot, or I... Yeah. Well, the thing is, I just have to spend too much time doing it, and I'm not in the mood for it.
But yeah. When he does the grabbing attack.
That's basically an insta kill.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter how powerful you get. Ah. I'm serious about that, by the way. It doesn't matter how powerful you get. Almost every single time when I get eaten, I die.
Huh.
Okay. But maybe I have... Well, no, I've been like the beefiest guy ever in my last two freaking playthroughs of this game, so... Whoops. I'm still quite sad you managed to go through this game when we are doing a co-op. Like, without a freaking shield, you are rolling constantly, which is amazing.
Yeah.
That's freaking amazing. Well, it's also really good, because right now you are so used to the rolling.
What the fuck? Why did you follow me? No, he ate me again. He's eating me again. You, son of a biscuit.
Son of a biscuit. I like that. Oh well. Did you die?
Yeah,
I died. Yeah, you died. Yeah. Oh wow, I have only one throwing knife. I thought I had more. Well, that's gonna be an issue for one upcoming part. Over here, then a dude from the corner attacks you. Then I stab this dude, and then he dives. There are more. Oh boy, that could have been bad. Okay, that is bad. Come on. It's so bad with that. Why does it feel so good? That's basically a motto for Dark Souls in general. It's so bad, but why does it feel so good? Every single time you die. Well, actually, dying doesn't feel good. It's when you win that feels good. It's all of the death before that makes your winning or your victory a lot more satisfying.
Yeah.
Also, something else that Dark Souls 2 does for... actually, I know the reason why. But the weapon durability in this game is really freaking low. Your weapons break really fast, so you should always have a double or some a couple of spare weapons. But the reason why this is because originally, in the original version of Dark Souls 2, this game was on 30 FPS, just like the original Dark Souls 1. So they changed it to Dark Souls, in Scarlet First Sin, they changed it to 60 FPS. Which, for some kind of a reason, basically made everything faster. And it made the durability downgrade 2 times faster. Also.
Okay.
So yeah, that's the reason why the durability is so bad. And you can't really fix it unless if you want to play in 30 FPS, but this game is not made for 30 FPS, so I wouldn't recommend it. Alright, here comes one of my least favorite early game freaking encounters. Oh boy. Oh shit. Jesus. Fuck off. Wait, let me just go and spam you with the dagger. There we go. Okay, I win. He says, menacing me. You know what's pretty funny? In I think in Fallout, you have like when you're fighting robots, you have like angered beeps. Like when you hear the beeping and there's like subtitles. It's like angry beeps and dying bleeps and all that jazz. And confused bleeps. It's freaking... I freaking love that. That's one of my favorite things about Fallout. Well, I haven't played Fallout before, but I have seen a lot of it already, because I didn't really expect ever playing it. It's with a lot of games, really, that I don't ever really expect myself playing the game. Ah, oh, crap. But, yeah. but I'm still interested in the game anyway, so there we go.
All bumps to the face.
At which point are you actually at?
I'm at the point where the guy is going to find one to the face with the mob.
With like all the hollows in the tree in the middle? Okay. I am at the point, like I'm basically right before the... before you get to the next bonfire. I took care of that really annoying encounter over here. With the firebombs and the archer and the dude up here.
Oh, you're over there already? What the fuck?
Well, yeah, you died. You were fighting and you died to the freaking ogre, so...
Yeah,
that takes some time. And I've noticed when we were playing, I think even when we were just playing it normally, like, you go through the game a lot slower than me.
Yeah.
I think you're more, like, you're more carefully thinking, well, I'm just rushing in and basically most of the time being lucky with my victories. Okay, I have 2,000 souls. That's a lot of souls to level, but unfortunately, I need these souls for something else.
Yay.
Buy something, anything.
I need a ring. Give it to me.
The thing is, I could buy the Lenegrass key, and then I can get into the. Well, I don't really need to be in the blacksmith shop, so I'm not gonna buy anything. I'm gonna talk until you move over to the next area.
Where did you?
It's high time I pick up and move. What did you say?
No, the guy that was supposed to be dead but was still alive for some reason.
Dead and alive. There we go. I'm really freaking happy. I think next time that one of my controller breaks, I think I'm just gonna buy an Xbox One controller. Well, the thing is, you have the PS4 controller, which right now is really optimized for a lot of things, but I am so used to the controls. From I'm so used to the controls and the button placement of the Xbox, then I'm just gonna get an Xbox One controller. And it would also work with basically all of the games that I play on Steam, so. And I think an Xbox One controller once, and it really wasn't too bad. I thought it was gonna be very confusing, but it really wasn't too horrible.
Sorry, Mike.
What did you say?
I hit it, Mike.
Oh.
I didn't put a label on it. It says Mike. It's like Mike, but Mike. Ow.
And we get a small white soapstone, which would technically allow us to do co-op, but only for 10 minutes, I think.
No, 15 minutes.
Or 15 minutes, but still, we don't have the ring, so we won't be able to connect to each other anyway. I found another summon sign over here. What is your name? Moths.
Hey, it's all nice.
Wait, did I even rest at the bonfire? Oh yeah, I did.
I don't know.
I'm gonna rest at it again. Because I don't want to die with 2,300 souls. Because I need to get more souls. The thing is, you are better equipped for basically this, like the first part of the game, while I'm just... I am squishy, I do basically no damage, and yeah.
Yeah.
Hmm. Oh, crap! Oof. There we go.
Oh,
shit. There you go. Also something else that I don't think we've said before, but we are recording both sides of the gameplay. So if you don't want to see me playing, well then you can switch over to Cube. If you don't want to see Cube playing, then you can switch over to me.
Yeah. Probably everyone's going to watch a Cube because I suck.
It depends what somebody likes. I like what people like.
Yeah.
Do you like to see winning and strategic thinking, or do you want to see idiocy and failure? Okay, no, I'm sorry, no, that I didn't mean that.
Yeah, who is who?
Oh crap! Yeah, no. Who is who? Find out next episode. Let me go and use a life gem. That's my final life gem. Okay. I don't think I'm gonna clear this area quite yet. I'm first gonna
continue. Don't die.
Don't die just yet. You can die when I'm done with you.
Yeah, correctly. If I rest at the bonfire, then you can die.
Oh, not crap, right. Jesus. Alright, yeah, there we go, that's what I needed. The ironclad blowing up with the freaking fireballs is really good.
Okay, I'm at the bonfire.
Oof. Oh, shit. I hate these ironclads.
How much souls do you need for the ring?
5,500 souls.
That sucks.
Ow. Well, the thing is, I'm like staying clear from the really dangerous parts. I'm just not getting anywhere close to the really dangerous parts. Did I get him? No, I didn't get him. Right now I'm trying to... Okay, fuck me. Okay, and another... What the hell? Another guy followed me from the other side of the frickin' world!
Oh, shit. I missed the Titanite.
Yeah, I also missed
Titanite
him.
Titanite demon.
But I couldn't even touch him.
A twinkling Titanite lizard.
It's a Titanite lizard. Or a crystal lizard. I'm sorry, it's a crystal lizard. That's the name.
Why is this so... Oh my god, how do I English? I think it's a trap. Oh no, it's not a trap. Okay, it's not a trap, it's fine, it's fine.
It's a trap! Come on, throw your firebomb at me. There you go. Man, this guy sucks at throwing firebombs. Come on! God damn it. Blow this up! Got him! Nice!
I'm gonna retry to get the Titanite lizard.
Yep. I am gonna use my pocket souls right now and I'm gonna hope that I have enough. I don't think that I'm gonna have enough, but you know what.
Come on. Fuck!
Okay. Yep.
Ah, screw it.
So, if you get all of... If you defeat all of the enemies... Or, yeah, I think if you defeat all of the enemies on the way and get all of the items, you have enough souls to by the ring, which I'm going to do right now.
Okay.
Then I can use the rest of my souls to hopefully level up. How is your soul memory looking?
It's looking like I... Hang on. Player status soul memory is saying 2790.
Okay, mine was 5910, but that's because I used them up my pocket souls.
Okay.
So there we go. I have the ring that we need.
I don't.
Let's see, which god are we gonna pick?
I don't know.
Sure, the goddess of bliss.
Sure.
Because we are swagalicious. Right now I just have to get to Pate. Is it Pate? Yeah. Yeah, it's Pate, yeah.
My name is Pate.
My name is Pate.
Maybe.
Maybe. No. Maybe not.
Probably not, haha. Wait. I don't know, I have to go to the fourth gate. Man, it's been a while since I played this game.
Same over here. That's a good thing, because I think we did a Let's Play like almost right after we were done with the co-op playthrough.
Oh, yeah.
Which is probably the reason why we didn't continue playing it, because we just weren't in the mood for Dark Souls 2.
Hey, you there, come and squish me, bitch. No.
No, don't actually do it!
Yes.
Ye ass. God damn it! I hate the range of the stinking dagger. Ow. There we go. Oh yes, finally got a better knife. And I can't use it because I don't have the amount of freaking dexterity that I need. And all of that because I didn't level up. Let's see, can I wear this? It's worse. That's better. This is the same. Oh, this is better. Okay. Let's heal up. So I'm basically doing everything before the... before the bonfire and the... You know which bonfire I mean. The bonfire with the witch.
Oh, come on. Blow up already.
So I'm also doing the area with all of the... Like, with the fire longsword in the chest. At the end of, like, the exploding place.
How am I still alive? Holy shit.
Did you hear what I said? Which... What yeah. I'm gonna do? Yeah, okay.
Good. Yeah, I was paying attention to my skin.
Yeah, that's no problem. It's no problem.
Yes, I really... Why?
Oh!
Do the thingy. To make the shortcut. Come on.
Come on. Because he sucks at throwing freaking firebombs.
No, but he is throwing right at.
Yeah, sometimes it's just really weird. Doesn't work always.
Yeah. That's crazy then.
Oh, just had a little bit of lag spike. Also, when you're looking on my screen, the chances of getting lag spikes are very much there. I'm playing on my laptop. I don't have that. I have a beefy laptop, but not a super beefy laptop. While he is playing on his fancy schmancy gaming PC. So yeah.
Hey, Paid.
Did you parry?
No, Paid.
Oh, Paid.
Yeah, Paid.
Oh, okay, that was a bad idea. Actually, I didn't go to Paid. I should do that first.
I first got to do the trap.
Oh, right, that's a difficult one.
Oh shit, I got.
You got parried?
Yeah, I got parried.
What? Crazy. A foot soldier shield. Let's take a gander. This thing has worse physical defense than...
Can you guys find ladders? Doesn't look like it. Why? Why, game, why?
What the hell is this? Okay, so whenever you dodge backwards and you try to throw something forward, your character throws it in the wrong direction.
Cool.
Yep, it's...
I got a firebomb, so I'm saved.
Cool.
Saved. I can do the shortcut now.
There we go. Oh, I get... Wow! I get old ironclad leggings.
Nice.
Ooh, sure. Nice. Oh, I don't have the strength that I need to... Holy crap. To equip this stuff. Because in this game you need strength to equip some, or you just need different stats to equip some pieces of armor, which they haven't done before.
I almost get off myself.
And how? Oh, by blowing it up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Do I have a freaking homer bone? I don't.
Man,
crap.
I'm already out of Estus.
Yeah, Estus in the beginning of the game is just ridiculous. Hey, do you want to try to take care of the pursuer?
Maybe.
Well, the thing is, you can do it. Well, actually, no, because then. Why? Because then you can't see the boss intro. Because if you kill him there, then he's dead for real. He won't come back to the boss battle.
Yeah, true.
I'm gonna die here. Don't feel confident enough in my abilities to survive this encounter. Especially since I don't have any other way of healing myself! Wow.
Okay.
I had no idea that I could make that sound.
That was special.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever made that sound in my life before. Wow, I think I was like some kind of an opera singer or something. Or how do you call it?
I never heard that. never in my life heard that.
That was an amazing sound.
Yeah,
I can use this sword now. Fuck off! No! Jesus! I really like that's actually something that I really do when I'm playing a game, and especially when we're doing a let's play or something, and something really unexpected happens, then I start making those sounds. Jeez, man, my room is getting really hot. I should really lower the temperature of my.
Fuck! I died.
You died?
Yeah, I died. I got raped. Basically.
You got raped?
Yeah.
Can I have more details, please? Excuse me?
Yeah, two hollows. The thingies. You know the little. Wherever the guy dropping firebombs at you?
Where they are oh yeah, that place, yeah.
Yeah, up there, at those guys. Yeah, they basically killed me.
They basically killed you, yeah.
Yeah. Basically.
I finally get to level up. Okay, there we go. I have enough strength to at least use a better weapon right now. Okay, I'm gonna go and see about getting the white side and soapstone. And then when I'm done with that, it's gonna be done on my end.
Oh, wow.
Because I have the ring, and then I would also have the other thing that we need to do co-op.
Okay, I'm gonna get my souls back.
Oh my god, I managed to parry. Nice. In this game, parrying is really difficult. Or at least I think it's difficult compared to the other games. And I parried again. Okay, cool.
I almost forgot a bow.
Oh yeah, bow. A bow in this game is really freaking good.
He fell off.
I'm gonna ignore this shitty encounter over here.
What? I got parried, but no.
You got parried, but no.
I got
no.
Yeah, exactly. I got parried, but. No, I died again. I died. Again.
Getting parried, though. I've never...
I,
Which enemy parries you?
Hollow or something. Yeah, everything is all great going.
Which hollows? The hollows with the pointy helmets, or the hollows with the
Pointy helmet.
With the pointy helmets. Wow, I've never had that happen to me before.
Don't die. Not now. That was stupid of me. Oh no, no. I live, apparently.
Okay. I'm alive? I'm still laughing at the sound I made. It's just so weird.
That was a pretty fun one.
Yeah, it's the same as with the oh sound that I made for the intro of Cryptek Gaming.
Yeah,
that's also a sound that just happens, and I don't know how to make it.
Magic. All right,
there we go. I made it. All right, and now should have the white shiny soapstone. There we go.
Okay, give me a minute.
give me half an hour.
Yeah, probably not half an hour. Oh.
You still have pockets full, by the way.
Yeah, true.
Alright, let's see if I can kill the Crystal Lizard. Or the Crystal Lizard. If he's even here anymore, because I don't think... Yeah, he respawns. Good. Keep thrusting. There you go. And I get Stite Knight Shards. Two of them. Nice.
I killed him. Haha.
And there goes some kind of a bus. Makes not a freaking sound. Let me go... What am I gonna do with my souls? Can I level up with your souls? I can. Let me go and level up again. That is one of, actually from this point onward, it's going to be one of the most important things for me to do, since my stats are crappy.
Fire one?
No,
don't have fire one. Ah, oh, that's the I have this.
Crab people. Think like crab. Eat like
taste
crab.
Like crab.
Crab. People. Yeah.
Oh damn it! Doesn't activate the fire piles. That's too bad.
Okay, I'm done on my end, so I'm not sure what I'm gonna do right now. Let's see.
No,
let me go back over to the Colonel Tower.
Fall damage.
How many souls do you have?
I have 51. 52. Oh fuck me.
Do you have 52 souls?
No, 5200.
Okay. I was like, huh? Alright. I think I'm gonna end it off. No, I'm not gonna end it off, I have to wait for you. Alright.
That's nice.
I'll probably make a cut in my video right now, when I'm not doing anything.
Okay, sure.
That's the lovely thing about this part. I can just edit it and I'll only show the useful stuff on my end, and then all the other stuff that you're doing gets shown on your end, of course.
Well, yeah, I'm also done, basically.
Yep, okay, that's good. Then you can end off the episode, and then we'll...
Okay, I hope...
Come over here again next episode. Cool.
If you did, please leave a like. If you didn't, like button. I'd see you guys in the next episode.
Goodbye!